What up, everybody? It's me, Bitchy, here back in another show. Actually, welcoming you to my mini-series entitled I'm Moving to LA. This is going to be just a few episode, little mini-series about my journey in moving to LA. I basically, to give you a little bit of backstory, I'm going to basically, no, I'm starting over. I don't know how to introduce this. What up, everybody? It's me, Bitchy, here back giving you another show. Actually, here welcoming you to my new mini series entitled DB Moves to LA. And basically, this is gonna just give you a little bit of insight on my journey to trying to move to LA, trying to make some dreams come true, and trying to basically change my life for the better. So, to make a long story short, actually, because I don't want to go too deep into everything basically on the first episode, but I have chosen to move to LA. I went to LA this past summer, last summer, with one of my best friends. That's my best friend. We went to LA, and I basically fell in love with it. The environment, the people, the sights, the sounds, the colors, the environment, you know, just going somewhere where nobody knew me and where I could just, you know, not really worry about being judged. So, backstory of why I want to move to LA. I want to move to LA, not, this isn't the sole reason why, but this is a big reason why. A lot of people either don't know this or may know this, but I suffer from depression. Yeah, I've been suffering from it my whole life, 27 years on this earth, you know, 80s baby, 88. Shout out to all the 80s babies. Don't know exactly why. How, what, when, where. There's a number of different things that either caused the depression or has sustained it in my life for this long. Not making any excuses. And before I go any further, I do want to say, for people who have friends or family who deal with depression, one of my biggest pet peeves and one of the biggest no-nos in the book of handling people with depression is telling people, you know, well, don't feel sorry for yourself and, oh, you're throwing yourself a pity party. And just kind of like shushing them off and sweeping them under the rug. That's one of my biggest pet peeves. No, I'm not feeling sorry for myself. I'm past that phase, you know, middle school, elementary school, was the feeling sorry for myself phase. And pity party, no, bitch, I'm not throwing a pity party. If I am throwing a pity party, I'm the only one invited. I don't want anyone to have pity for me or feel sympathy for me for making this video. I'm just making this video because I use it as therapy. My YouTube videos have honestly been the one thing that I could say has kept me alive. Not that I would ever do anything to myself. I would never do anything to hurt myself. I'm too big of a coward. I'm not about to hang myself. I'm not about to cut my wrist or do anything like that and taking a lot of medicine. I don't like to take some medicine, so I'm not going to do any of that stupid stuff, but my YouTube videos are definitely one of the reasons why I could say I'm still alive. Being able to come on YouTube and express my feelings through comedy and through music and parodies and videos and all that stuff, even if nobody watches it and people want to say, oh, you suck and, you know, stuff like that, I don't care. It's fine. It's my therapy. So that's what that is. So, yeah, don't tell people, you know, pity party and stuff like that, because I have noticed people who, families and friends who have dealt with suicide, you know, they say, oh, well, I wish they would have come to me and I wish they would have talked to me and, you know, come and let me know what was going on with them. And I say to myself, you know, well, they tried and it seemed like you just told them that they were feeling sorry for themselves or that they were, you know, throwing a pity party and they needed to, you know, do something about it. Instead of actually being a listening ear more than anything, I don't need anyone to feel sympathy or, you know, have, you know, sympathy for me. I just need a listening ear sometimes. Listening ear is all that I need. So that's why I do YouTube, because I know people are listening. I see people are watching the videos, and I know people are listening. Listening ear. So, yeah, depression is just something that I've always dealt with, being, first of all, gay and black. Two strikes already right there. Gay and black. I'm also, you know, a thicker girl. I might not look it in the face right now because I'm coming down a little bit trying to get in shape, but I'm a thicker girl, you know? So when you're a bigger girl in the gay community, you know, you're not looked at. You know, these queens on their Jacked and Grinders, you know, that I use for my promotional videos, you could check me out on there, Duro Bitchy on those sites, not looking for sex like everybody else. But they blatantly put in there no fats, no femmes, no gays, no straights, no, you know, DLs, no scammers, and all, you know, they just put it in their prerequisite that, you know, they don't want a thick girl. So right off the bat, that's a strike right there. You know, being fat, nobody wanting me. Having one relationship in 27 years with a now sugar baby is like, you know, why, basically. So that's a big depression thing. My little brother and little sister, very proud of them. I feel like I'm not a good big brother to them. You know, I just feel like I'm just very sheltered or shunned or something like that. Not by them, but I just have put myself in a box to where I'm just very quiet and very, I don't know. I'm going to explain more, but let's keep going. So, you know, my brother and sister, they both have, brother has a girlfriend, a beautiful son, my nephew, who's a maze ball, slays all the other babies. Sorry, Blue Ivy. Sorry, Wiz and Amberell's son. Benjamin Cole is the new baby tease. Sister has an amazing boyfriend who's very nice, seems like he loves her, does everything for her. And, you know, it's just like I'm the odd person out. I'm the, you know, the firstborn but the worstborn. Because, you know, I don't have a career, I don't have love or anything like that. But thankfully, I'm one of those depressed people who, like I said, I use my YouTube to curb all of that, even thinking about it and just stupid shit like that. I just don't even think about that. I use my YouTube to get my mind off of it and keep my mind busy to think about other things other than those things. Also, friendship-wise, I don't have any friends. I'm kind of feel bad about saying that, but it's the truth. I don't have any friends. Because of me being depressed, people have different notions about me. They think I'm either a bitch. I don't answer the phone. I don't answer text messages, calls. I'm not a really big talker. I'm going to say that right now on camera. I don't like talking on the phone. I don't know why. Could be depression. I don't know. But I just don't like talking on the phone. I will text you till my fingers fall off, but I just don't like talking on the phone sometimes. I don't know why. And just sometimes I'm just disconnected from the world. Sorry. And I'm saying sorry to all those people now because I've lost some good friends. Let's get this straight. I've lost some good friends because of depression. You know, me not answering, me maybe not being available all the time, not having money, and, you know, job to job. And I'm going to get to that, too, because I've had people judge me on jobs and stuff like that. But, you know, I've lost some good friends because of it, and I've also lost bad friends who I had to clock them and let them know, bitch, I might be depressed, I might be stupid, naive, and dumb, but I can clock tea better than a clock on the wall. So I've got rid of the bad people and also lost some good people. And I've hurt people, I've done things that I never wanted to do in life, things that I'm very embarrassed about, things that I've wanted to kill myself about, but never would kill myself. Like I said, it's just because somebody thinks something doesn't mean they're going to do it. I'm definitely not going to do it. Like I said, I'm afraid. I don't like the taste of medicine, so I'm not going to drink a whole thing of medicine. Not about to hang, bitch, my fat ass hanging from a fucking wooden thing's going to break it. And just stupid stuff like that. So I'm not at all like that. Then this is why I'm moving to LA. And then, like, with jobs, I'm so passionate about doing what I love to do, being on camera, being on the radio, reporting news, making videos, taking pictures, splicing things that they pop in and out and splice in and out. You know, I'm so passionate about doing that I don't give a fuck that I've had a lot of jobs. Yes, I've had a lot of jobs. I go from job to job because I don't want to settle for a Target or a Walmart. Not saying that anything's wrong with that, but when I have dreams of doing that, it's like I'm helping them build their dreams, but I'm not doing anything to accomplish mine. You know, I've seen friends and family who have accomplished their dreams. Shout out to fucking Perry. I have to say that, Perry. Who's from Bolingbrook, just like me. He is the fucking leader of a crew, of a drum. He did what I wanted to do. He's doing what I want to do and basically saying fuck everybody else and just doing what he loves to do on a daily basis. And he may have a real job, I don't know, but he gets to do that in his spare time. So just shout out to him, and I'm very happy for him and all of his success. And I'm actually trying to follow that. Saying all of that, like I said, moving to LA, I went to LA, fell in love with it. I see myself going there, starting an entirely new chapter in life, going somewhere where people don't really know me, so they're not going to be able to judge me like, you know, the people who are around me now are able to. And just being happy, you know, the sun, the weather, the tourists, the people, the spots, the hot spots. I'll be able to do a lot more with my show, bitch, go down to Santa Monica Pier and perform one of my, like, 100 remixes that I have. Go ahead and check that out. Going to, you know, Hollywood Boulevard and getting a tourist and, you know, stopping them. And what do you think about the Bernie Sanders controversy? How do you feel about Bernie? And, you know, reporting and doing things that I can't really do in Chicago. Sorry, but I'm over Chicago. It's 27 years. There's too much violence. I can't go out on the street. I may be, hi, what do you think about Hillary Clinton? Give me your wallet. Bow, bow. I can't do that. So I'd rather go somewhere where I can be happy. And even if I am having a down day, bitch, I can go to the beach. I can go to Disneyland. I can go to Hollywood Boulevard. I can go to West Hollywood, see Caitlyn Jenner or one of the Kardashians driving by or something like that. Go on a TMZ tour. Go on a wax museum tour. Go do a lot of stuff. So I'm moving to LA. And the crazy thing is that I don't have a lot of money. I have a little bit of savings, you know, saved up. But I'm basically going out there with like maybe $2,000, $3,000. And I'm going to hopefully make that work. I'm thinking about starting a GoFundMe, but I don't have a sad sob story to tell. And usually those GoFundMes are for like really tough things. So I just don't want to be a nobody anymore. I don't want to feel like a nobody. I want to go somewhere where I can feel like I'm somebody and be happy and just do things on my terms and build a new personality and identity and all of that stuff. So I definitely will be doing that. I have screenplays, I have music, I have videos, I have movies, I'm acting, I want to do a lot of stuff. So I'm just going to follow my dream, because if I don't follow it now, I'm almost 30, going to be 28 this year. Still have a few years in my 20s, so don't get it twisted. You know, I still look like I'm 20-something, so no shade there. And, you know, I just feel like if it's not now, it's never. Do or die, gotta do it now. Can't keep putting it off. So wish me luck, y'all. If you want to donate to the GoFundMe for me to go out there and write my screenplays and write my short films and film my short films and make my videos and take this YouTube thing to the next level, because I could really live off of YouTube. I don't have to have a job. If I had more followers and more viewers and more people to help get the word out there and different things like that, I could live off of YouTube. I don't have to go work at a Target and help, you know, the Waltons at Walmart's dreams come true. I can make the Braxtons and Daryl and, you know, son of Shannon and Daryl, you know, son's dream come true. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I just wanted to get that off of my chest. This is the first episode of DB Moves to LA. I will be documenting my search for an apartment, my search for a job, my search for everything, basically. So if you have any tips, if anybody out there lives in LA, has any connections with jobs, needs a roommate, somebody to, you know, help out on the rent a little bit, put a little bit of coins on the rent, you know, the utilities, hit me up, you know, follow me on Twitter at lookat_dnow88, follow me on Instagram at dnice1288, and follow me on Snapchat at the 1288 or something like that on Snapchat. I'm ready for this journey. I just feel liberated in talking about it, because I have never really talked about it on camera. But one time, you can go back and find out the whole story of the depression and where it stems from. If you want to go back and watch that video, go ahead. It's old now. You know, nobody really came to me after it. So, but yeah, follow me on Twitter, and deuces. LA, I'm coming, bitch.